Hello and welcome to this session on the basic architecture of Kubernetes. If you have worked in teams, we have a manager in a team and then we have multiple team members, and the manager manages these team members and together they form a team. Now Kubernetes work in the same way. In this session, we are going to see in a very easy and very interesting way the basic architecture of Kubernetes. So let's get started. Welcome, I'm Raghav. I'm a teacher and you can find all my work on my website automationstepbystep.com. In this session, we are going to see and learn the basic architecture of Kubernetes. Now in this session, I will go very basic step by step. So do not worry if you have no prior knowledge on this topic. We will see a very basic architecture and components and an overview of Kubernetes. We will also learn what is master, worker, pods, and cluster in a very easy and basic way. Now, in Kubernetes, we have a master. You can think of master as a manager in a team, and then we have worker nodes, and you can think of worker nodes as team members in a team. So we have a master and worker nodes, and together they form a team or a cluster. So the master manages these workers and they form a team, and in Kubernetes, we call this as a cluster. Now, when we deploy Kubernetes, we actually get a cluster, and a cluster is made up of nodes or a set of machines which are called as nodes. We have master nodes and worker nodes, and there should be at least one worker node and at least one master node to form a cluster. In the earlier days of Kubernetes, the worker nodes were called as minions, although we no longer refer to them as minions, we call them worker nodes or just nodes, and for master we call it as master or a master node. Also in Kubernetes, every cluster has at least one master node and at least one worker node. There can also be more than one master nodes in a cluster, and this may be required to get the features of failover and high availability. And in Kubernetes architecture, there can also be multiple clusters. Now with this knowledge and with this information, let us move ahead and let me change or replace these images with the actual boxes for master and the worker nodes, and this forms the entire cluster in Kubernetes. Now we also need to understand about nodes and pods in Kubernetes. In the session of features of Kubernetes, I had very briefly discussed about nodes and pods. So a node can be a physical machine, a virtual machine, or can be a virtual machine on cloud. And inside a node, we have pods. They can be one or multiple pods in a node. And inside a pod, we have containers like Docker containers, and they can be one or multiple containers in a pod. So we have this architecture of Kubernetes where we have master, worker nodes. The nodes will have pods, pods will have containers. The master node manages both worker nodes and the pod. Some very useful information about the limits of all these components that we can have in a cluster or in Kubernetes. So as per the latest version of Kubernetes, as per the time of recording this video, a cluster can have a max of 5000 nodes, and to be very specific, the limit for nodes in a cluster is 5000, and the limit for pods is 150,000, and then the total number of containers that we can have is 300,000, and then for a single node there cannot be more than 100 pods. So these are the limits or the numbers that you should always remember. So I believe now you understand the very basic architecture and components of Kubernetes. To summarize, when you deploy Kubernetes, you get a cluster. A cluster has nodes, worker nodes and master nodes. A worker node will have pods, and pods will have containers, and they can be multiple worker nodes in a cluster. And then we have a master, one or more master in a cluster, and the master manages the nodes and the pods in a cluster. So this is the very basic overview of the Kubernetes architecture. I will have another session where we will go more deeper into the architecture of Kubernetes. I hope this session was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.